हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी स्टडी क्लास 10 साइंस चैप्टर 9 हेरिडिटी एंड एवोल्यूशन इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चन आंसर्स।
हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एनएसपी लर्निंग हब, बिकॉज लर्निंग इज लाइफ।
स्टूडेंट्स, आवर क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 इज डिफाइन द टर्म एवोल्यूशन। एवोल्यूशन कैन नॉट बी इक्वेटेड विद प्रोग्रेस। जस्टिफाई दिस स्टेटमेंट। एवोल्यूशन, evolution is the gradual and continuous change in the traits of an individual that accumulated and enable it to survive better in its surroundings. Evolution cannot be equated with progress from lower organism to higher organism. Evolution leads to the production of diversity and the shaping this diversity by environmental selections. स्टूडेंट्स, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज नेम द साइंटिस्ट हु गेव द थ्योरी ऑफ एवोल्यूशन। द आंसर इज चार्ल्स डार्विन। ही गेव द थ्योरी ऑफ एवोल्यूशन। ड्यूरिंग एवोल्यूशन ऑर्गेन्स और फीचर्स मे अडेप्टेड फॉर न्यू फंक्शंस। एक्सप्लेन दिस फैक्ट बाय चूजिंग एप्रोप्रिएट एग्जाम्पल। द एग्जाम्पल इज डायनासोर्स। दे हैड फेदर फॉर इंसुलेशन इन कोल्ड वेदर, बट इन केस ऑफ बर्ड्स दे वर यूज फॉर फ्लाइंग। स्टूडेंट्स, अवर नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज नेम द प्लांट मेंडल यूज फॉर हिज एक्सपेरिमेंट इन F1 एंड F2 जनरेशन। व्हेन ही क्रॉस्ड टॉल एंड शॉर्ट प्लांट्स, राइट द रेशियो ही ऑब्टेन्ड इन F2 जनरेशन। मेंडल यूज पी प्लांट, व्हिच बॉटनिकल नेम इज पाइजम सटाइवम फॉर हिज एक्सपेरिमेंट। When Mendel crossed tall and short plant, the progeny obtained in F1 generation were tall. These are the parents. This is pure tall and pure dwarf. When they cross between them, the F1 generation obtained all tall plants. When the F1 plants were self, the F2 generation show 3 tall and 1 dwarf plant. When selfing of F1 is done, then the 4 types of genotypes we obtain. Pure T is pure dominant, these two are hybrids and one is dwarf. So the phenotypic ratio in F2 generation is 3:1, which means 3 tall and 1 dwarf, and the genotypic ratio in F2 generation is 1:2:1, in which 1 is pure dominant, 2 is hybrids and 1 is pure recessive. Next question is, how do Mendel experiment show that traits may be dominant or recessive? Mendel conducted the monohybrid cross, the cross between one contrasting character, between pure tall and pure dwarf plant, and observed only tall pea plants in the F1 generation. But on selfing, the F1 progeny, both tall and dwarf plant, were observed in F2 generation in the ratio 3:1. The appearance of tall character in both F1 and F2 generation shows that tallness to be a dominant character. But absence of dwarf character in F1 generation and its reappearance in F2 generation confirmed that dwarfness is a recessive character. Students, our next question is, how do Mendel experiment show that inheritance of two traits is independent of each other? Mendel conduct dihybrid cross, the cross between two contrasting character, and observe that when he start with two types of parents, he obtain 4 types of individuals in F2 generation. For example, he crossed the round green seeded plant with wrinkled yellow seeded plants. He observed that in F1 generation, all plants have round and yellow seeds. And on selfing, the 4 types of seeds plants are observed. The appearance of new hybrids or recombination in F2 generation along with parental type characters show that traits are inherited independently of each other. Students, our next important question is, differentiate between acquired and inherited trait with examples. Acquired trait, these are somatic variations. Somatic means all cells other than genetic cells. and inherited traits are the genetic variations. It is developed due to environmental factor, use and distinguish between organ and special efforts. It is developed due to reshuffling of genetic material and due to mutation. These traits develop throughout the lifetime of an individual, while inherited traits are transferred or inherited by the parents to their offspring. Examples of acquired traits are learning of dance and music and muscular body of a wrestler. An example of inherited traits are curly hairs and eyeball colors. Students, our next question is, how is the sex of child determined in human beings? Human beings have 22 pair of autosomes and 1 pair of sex chromosome. This pair is XX for female and XY for male. The cross show that female produce all similar gametes of X, while male produce 2 types of gametes, 50% with X and 50% with Y chromosomes. When a female gamete fuses with a male gamete with X chromosome, a girl is born. But when a female gamete fuses with a male gamete having Y chromosome, a boy is born. So it is only male which determine the sex of a child. Students, our next important question is, state 2 difference between homologous and analogous organs. Homologous organ. Homologous organ have same basic structural designs, whereas in analogous organs have different basic structural designs. Homologous organ perform different functions in different organisms, for example, for limbs of frog and birds. In analogous organs, they perform similar function in different organisms, for example, wings of birds and bats. Students, our next important question is, what are fossils? List 3 roles of fossils in tracing evolutionary relationships. Fossils, the remains of dead plants and animals which were buried under the rocks millions of years ago are called fossils. Roles of fossils in tracing evolutionary relationships are, fossils and their study is useful in knowing about the species which are no longer alive. The fossils of different organisms have some features similar to one species, while some features are similar to the other species. So they show the link between 2 species. Fossils are also useful in forming a sequence of organisms in the pathway of evolution. Students, our next question is, what is mean by speciation? List 4 factors that could lead to speciation. Which of these cannot be major factor in speciation of self-pollinated plant species? Justify your answer. Speciation, the process by which new species developed from the existing species by evolution or any other genetic modification of previous species is known as speciation. Factors that could lead to speciation are, number 1, geographical isolation, which means migration of the population caused by various types of barriers like mountains, ranges, rivers, seas, etc. Due to this, there is no flow of genes between separated population of the same species occur. So, new species is developed. Number 2, genetic drift caused by the drastic change in the frequency of a particular genes by change alone. It means the sequence of the genes are changed. So, new species is formed. Number 3, variation caused in individual due to natural selection. It means environmental factors select the new species. Number 4, mutation. Drastic change in the genes or DNA is known as the is also caused the speciation, in which the DNA sequence change or 1 or 2 genes added or deleted. So the new species is developed. Reproductive isolation cannot be a major factor in speciation of self-pollinated plant species because it does not develop of any other species for its reproduction.